Pets forward as I stand here that I may bless them. Coming forward.
This is just another day for the Reverend James Thompson in his capacity as spokesman for God's defenceless creatures. His special services for animals attract the young and old alike, who come in one by one to be blessed by the Reverend Thompson. He believes firmly that God's concern and compassion extends to animals as well as humans.
James, that was a lovely service. There can't be many vicars, though, who look down into the congregation and there's a load of rabbits and birds in cages and Alsatian dogs. Why do you do it?
Well, to go back to the example of the Old Testament, Noah. I mean, there was room in the ark for the animals as well as for human beings. The trouble is the church has left them out. And in the last day, in the last book of the Bible, we read that the Good Shepherd, the Lord Jesus Christ, who became man for our salvation, he's portrayed figuratively as a lamb, as an animal.
What do you think the animals get out of it and the owners who bring them?
I sense that the animals themselves feel the presence of God, have no doubt about that. They felt the presence of God in the service this morning. And people talk, so many people in the church say, fancy bringing animals into the house of God. It'll cause a tremendous commotion. Believe me, some of the christenings I've taken have been far, far noisier.
Let me ask you the big question. Why has the church turned its back on these signs?
I think it's due to a pagan philosophy which at an early stage crept into the Christian church after the New Testament era. There was Aristotle's philosophy in the Greek world, and of course Aristotle's philosophy, which was absolutely pagan, and denied an immortal soul to animals. Only human beings had immortal souls. And his philosophy crept in to the Western church, and through a theologian called St. Thomas Aquinas, animals were looked upon as having no rights and no immortal soul. And if only the church of that period had followed the example of St. Francis of Assisi more than St. Thomas, I believe the world would be a far better place today.